Hi, my name is Angie Veith, and I'm a lecturer in the Department of Psychology and Neuroscience. I'm also the Associate Director of Undergraduate Studies for the Psychology program. The purpose of this video is to introduce you to the various ways our students can get involved in research during their time at Duke. There are many, as you will see. Before I get started, I'd like to mention that I'm one member of a team in the Office of Undergraduate Studies. Our director is Dr. Bridget Hard. Our program coordinator is Natalia Silva Harwood, and our staff assistant is Brooke Shaw. Although all of us have somewhat different duties, our goal is the same, and that is making sure that you as a major achieve what you want to achieve during your time here. It's our hope that all of our majors will at least consider getting involved in research during their time at Duke. All of these pictures show a recent graduate involved in research activities with a graduate student mentor. In fact, all of these students ended up doing a senior thesis in psychology. But the question is, how did they get started? What pathways did they take? There are several pathways for our students. I'm going to spend the first portion, the longest portion of this video, talking about these pathways, starting with the least formal and going through the most intensive. And then near the end of the recording, I'm going to talk about various ways our students are supported in the research, both through the department and through other bodies at Duke. One of the first exposures that students have to research is through their coursework, especially the Psychology 204L and 205L sequence, which is the required research methods and data analysis sequence for our majors. The curricula for these classes is set up so that students will learn to be critical consumers of research. They'll get practice writing proposals. They'll even get their own experience conducting research from start to finish. Of course, these aren't the only classes where students get involved in research. Any class that carries an R code is known to have a significant emphasis on research. So it will explore things like how the field goes about coming up with new knowledge and how that knowledge is applied. Many students are quite excited about the prospect of research based on experiences in their coursework. So how can they get involved? One way is through volunteering in a lab. This is sometimes the only option for students who are unable to, for whatever reason, take advantage of one of the other options I'll be going into as we go along. In this case, student approaches professor, they negotiate some kind of terms, how many hours per week will the student help, what kinds of projects will they help with, and so on. So this is all quite informal. There's no class for it, there's no payment, it's simply volunteering in a lab, and it's always an option to inquire about. Probably a more common entry point for students to get involved in research is through the Psychology 203 prac. This is a half-credit pass-fail course. It does not count toward the major or minor, although it does count toward the 34 units required for graduation. There is an expected time commitment. This is a class, and so the expectation is that students will spend a certain amount of time assisting with activities in the lab, although it may differ somewhat from one lab to the other. The activities that students take part in also may differ from one lab to the other or from one semester to the other in even the same lab. Prac students might do things that range from conducting literature searches and literature reviews, to coding data, cleaning data, to scheduling and running participants through protocols, to attending weekly lab meetings, which can be very instructive, by the way. Students in prac are supervised by either the faculty member or graduate students or postdocs in the lab, sometimes lab managers, but they are supervised and the hope is that they will learn a lot in the process. In fact, the prac is really a great way to become acquainted with the lab, including the culture of the lab, as well as an overall research program. Sometimes practicum students are very excited by what they have been exposed to in prac and want to carry it a step further, want to do their own research on a relevant question. Those students might enroll in research independent study. Research independent study, like the research prac, is a class, although it is a full credit class and it is on a regular graded basis, which means that it can count toward the major. Up to two research independent study classes may count toward the major or minor. The hope is that at the beginning of the term, or even before the term has started, that the student and mentor will have negotiated what topic the student will be addressing and precisely what kind of project the student will be doing over the course of the term. There are requirements, of course. For instance, there's an expectation that the student and faculty mentor will meet regularly over the course of the term, and that the student will produce a scholarly paper at the end of the term outlining their findings. It's worth noting that sometimes research independent study students are also expected to put in additional time in the lab on top of meeting with their research mentor and working on their own project. Many times, students who are doing research independent study in a lab will already have been affiliated with the lab either through doing volunteering or a research prac, but that's not always the case. Sometimes research independent study is the student's first affiliation with the lab. The most intensive research experience available to our students is the honors thesis, which leads to graduation with distinction. This is a great option for students who have passion about a particular research topic and want to cover it more deeply, really make it the capstone of their experience as a psychology major at Duke. The honors thesis also is a signal to graduate schools, professional schools, even employers about a student's scholarliness and level of commitment. There are several requirements for the honors thesis, and I'll tick through them really quickly right now. There is a minimum GPA requirement, both overall and for the major. Students who want to do an honors thesis must take two research independent study classes associated with that particular topic. They enroll in the Psychology 496 Distinction Thesis Workshop, usually during the senior spring. Of course, they write a thesis, and they defend that thesis in front of a faculty committee. The last thing is that they present their research at Visible Thinking, which is a research poster session hosted by the Undergraduate Research Support Office every spring. Students who are serious about doing a senior honors thesis might consider applying to the Psychology Vertical Integration Program going into their senior year. This is a 9-week summer research program. And what's involved with it? The students, first and foremost, are working with a graduate mentor and a graduate student mentor, hence the vertical component. You have a faculty mentor, a graduate student mentor, and then the undergraduate researcher. They're working on the research that they think might turn itself into a thesis. They also are attending programming, including seminars put on by faculty and professional development workshops. And then the VIP culminates with students presenting their work, not just to the VIP community, but also to the larger university community. As I suggested, VIP is intended for rising seniors who are doing GWD. But students in other situations have applied and have taken part in the past. This photo is from our VIP cohort in 2019. During 2020, we had a virtual VIP, and that went very well also. The students in our department who are engaged with research have several options for funding and support. I've already mentioned Psychology VIP, which is pertinent to students who are going for distinction. Here's a picture of a VIP program seminar from a couple years ago. But there are other options available to students who aren't necessarily going for an honors thesis. For instance, the Undergraduate Research Support Office has many different types of awards available for students to apply for. Some of these grants cover expenses associated with research like software, materials and supplies, human subjects payment, and the like. The URS office also offers a summer research fellowship, and several of our students have taken advantage of that in the past. PNN itself also offers grants to our students who are doing research, sometimes over and above what they've received from elsewhere. So there are grants to cover the same kinds of expenses I mentioned a moment ago, but there's grants also to cover things like conference attendance, which can be really very helpful for students who are engaging in research in a big way. All of this funding and support is thanks to generosity by Trinity College of Arts and Sciences and also the Charles Lafitte Foundation, which made a very generous gift to our department a few years ago. Both of these bodies have done so much to help support our students in their research endeavors. So that's a lot of material that I just shared with you. I imagine you have questions too. Questions like, how do I find a research mentor? Excellent question, but not one that can be answered in a video like this. We encourage you to reach out about questions like that or any question. Reach out by email or set up a time to meet virtually with Natalia Silva-Harwood. Natalia knows basically everything, but there are times when she might refer you to one of the other people in our office, Dr. Hard, myself, Brooke Shaw, depending on the nature of the questions you're wondering about. Anyway, we hope that you'll take advantage of that, and we look forward to hearing from you soon. Thank you.